The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 13, 1972, in Ahmedabad, India.
Maya Sapta Mana Partha, Jugam Jinyan Madhatraya. Asaṃkhāṁ samagraṁ māṁ yathā gheṣṣasi tatchino. So, by the end of the 6th chapter, Krishna has explained the astāṅga-yoga-siddhi. Astāṅga-yoga-siddhi that Yogi nama ki sarvesam adgata antaratmana. Always he is thinking of Krishna within himself. Saddhavan with faith and knowledge. He is first class yogi. So how this first class yoga system helped me? Because the other yoga system, they disagree that simply by thinking of Krishna within one's heart, how one becomes perfect. That is explained from the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. How simply by understanding Krishna, you become well aware of everything. This yoga system. In the Vedas also it is stated, Jasmin vijñāte sarvametam vijñātam bhavanti. If you simply understand Krishna, then you know everything. Krishna is the root of everything. Therefore Krishna says, Sri Bhagavan Uvasa. We should always remember that this Bhagavad Gita is being spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, no one better authority. And God is speaking about Himself. Otherwise, by speculation you cannot understand God. That is not possible. You have to hear from God Himself about God. Athāpi tīdī mupadām bhujadvayam prasāda leśānu grhīta evahi jānāti tattam na chānāyī kopi chiraṁ vichinna. A person who has got little favor, atāpi te deva padam, little favor from the lotus feet of your lordship, he jānāti tattam, he knows what is tattam, what is absolute truth. Atāpi te deva padam ujaddayam prasāda leśānu prasāda leśānu. Little favor, not all. Prasāda leśānu grhīta evahi jānāti tattam. Nacha anya chiraṁ vichinnaṁ. Others may go on speculating for years and years. It is not possible to understand. So similarly, in the Brahma Saṅhita, another Vedic literature, it is said, Panthāsu kūti satavattha sampragamya vāyūrathāpi manasu munipungavāna. Munipungavāna, great saintly person sages, if they have traveled for millions of years, Panthāsu kūti satavattha, koti again multiplied by hundreds and hundreds. Vayurathapi, on the airplane of air, not this metal airplane, it is actually air airplane, or by the airplane of mind. Mind speed, we know. Mind can run within a second many thousands of miles, immediately. Suppose I am sitting here, so I have got my apartment in Los Angeles, 10,000 miles away. I can immediately. This is called mind speed. So with the mind speed, with the velocity of air, if one runs on to find out the Krishna planet or Krishna, still abhichinta tatte, still it is inconceivable tatte. Santhasu kuti satavatsa sambravamma vayu rathati manasu munipungavan sapasti japrapadatina abhichinta tatte govindamari purisam tamaham bhajan. Govinda is very, very difficult to understand by mental speculation. Philosophical thesis, speculation without religion is simply waste of time. And religion without philosophical basis is sentient. They must be combined together. So Bhagavad Gita is that. Religion combined with philosophy. If you simply take philosophy, it is dry speculation. No juice. Charbita charmanana, chewing the chew. There is no benefit. And if you simply take religion without basis of philosophy, then it is fanaticism. That's all. So both should be combined. Religion based on philosophy and logic. That is it. So that combination is Bhagavad Gita. So here, in the same chapter beginning, opening chapter, it is said, Bhagavan Uvas. You are searching after God. Now, here is God Himself speaking. So, recognize God by all sages, Vyasadeva, Narada, Asita, and later on, by Ramanucharya, by Shankaracharya, by Madhvacharya, by Vishnu Swami, by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then our Guru Maharaj. So our method is very simple. Evam parampara pratam imam rajasaya vidu. So we accept this parampara system. I may not know what is God, but because my predecessors, acharyas, confirm it, we hear it, Bhagavan. We accept it. That's all. We save so much trouble by mental speculation. We accept the parampara system, therefore, and we get the result. So, that is the way. Now here, not only the parampara system begins from Krishna. As Krishna says in the fourth chapter, Imam Vivasati Yugam Praptamana Homabhyam. I spoke first to the sun god. It is not said first. Many times he has said to many predominating deities. But in this era, this is called the age of Vaivasvata Manu. There are 14 manus in one day of Brahma. So Vaivasvata Manu is the eighth Manu. That means we are passing through the midday of this era, Manantara. There is 14 monos in one day of Brahma, and this era is called Vivasatamon, because he is the son of Vivasan, and that Vivasan is given reference in the fourth chapter. Imam Vivasati Yugam Praptavana Havabhyam. So if you simply calculate the age of Mano, it becomes 40 million of years. So Bhagavad Gita is not a new thesis. It is coming from time immemorial. So Krishna is the original preceptor. So here Krishna again, personally speaking, the authority, personally, out of compassion and friendship, love to Arjuna, he is speaking directly to Arjuna. And Arjuna understood him, the Supreme Personality of God. Parabrahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan. Purusham. Purusham. Purusham means person. Not in-person. In-person is the another feature of this person. Brahmana aham pratistha. Krishna says that the Brahma Jyoti, impersonal Brahma, that is situated upon me. Aham pratistha. Just like we are sitting on this platform. This is pratistha. Similarly, the Brahma Jyoti is situated on the person of Krishna. The person is the ultimate understanding of the Absolute Truth, not the impersonal teacher. That is preliminary understanding or imperfect understanding. There is Brahma Jyoti. Just like we are experiencing the sun sign. The sun sign is also experience of the sun god, but it is imperfect understanding. It is not perfect understanding. If you want to understand the sun god, then you have to penetrate through the sun sign and reach the sun planet. And then if you are able to see the predominating deity of the sun planet, whose name is Vivasana. Similarly, the whole material creation is a part of the Brahma Jyoti. Sarvam idam khalu Brahma. You have to penetrate in the Isopanishad. It is said, that you kindly wind up your Brahma Jyoti so can I can see your face rightly. So ultimately, there is person. Tattavas vadanti tattavidas satyam jadgyanam adyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaniti sadhya. This is Vaishnava. So Brahma realization is for the persons who are trying to understand the absolute truth by philosophical speculation. That is the understanding. Similarly, the localized Paramatma feature is realized by the yogis. Dhyanavasthitena tadgatena manasa pashyanti jam yogi. And the devotees, they realize directly the Supreme Personality of God, Bhagavan, Sarvaisajya Bhagavan, with full richness, full reputation, full strength, full knowledge, full renunciation. This is the meaning of Bhagavan. I have already explained. So that Bhagavan is speaking. The Maya Sattamana Prat, those who have developed attachment for me, Maya Asakta. Only attached to Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness, always thinking of Krishna. Maya Asakta Mana Pratha Yogam Jinjan Madasraya. This is yoga. It is already explained by the end of the sixth chapter. Yoginam ki sarvesam madgata antanatma. One who has developed attachment for Krishna, he has come to perfection simply by developing. And this development of attachment is possible by this Akshan Vidhi. Just like rising early in the morning, offering Mangala Arati, then changing the dress, garlanding, dressing, so many things. From morning 4 to up to night at 10 o'clock, there is program. That is real temple worship. Not that the temple is closed whole day and night and the pujari goes for 5 minutes and bell is again closed. No. There is system. Sri Vigraharadhana Nittanana Singharatan Mandiramajanaru. So many activities in temple worship. So for the Kanishnadhikari, neophytes, those who are serious to become, to awaken his attachment for Krishna, they must take to this Archan Marg. This is called Archan Marg. Temple worship. Everyone can establish a small temple in his house. And he can begin family-wise, himself, his wife, his children. That is what this Krishna consciousness movement wants to see, that every house has become a temple of Krishna. That is our program. Maya Shakti, just to increase the attachment for Krishna. That is needed, especially for the Grihastha. For the householders, still, in India, there are many respectable families. They are maintaining a small temple. Therefore, Krishna says, Suchinang Simatangehi Yoga Bhrashta Sanjaya. Yoga Bhrashta. This Yogam Jinjan Madhasvaya. This Bhakti Yoga. One who could not finish the 10% Bhakti Yoga in one life, at least he is guaranteed to have next life as a human being. Because Krishna says, Suchinam Simatangihi Yoga Bhrashta Sanjaya. Suchinam. Suchinam means first class Brahmana, Vaishnava. They are called Suchi. The Suchi, just the opposite word is Muchi. Muchi means most nasty habit, and Suchi means most clean habit. So, one poet said, the Suchi hoy, Muchi hoy, jodi Krishna taji. Muchi hoy, Suchi hoy, jodi Krishna bhaji. If one becomes Krishna conscious, even though he is born in the family of Muchi, he becomes Suchi. And even though one is born in the family of Suchi, Brahmana, if he rejects Krishna, he becomes Muchi. The Suchi hai Muchi hai Jodi Krishna bhaje. And Suchi hai Muchi hai Jodi Krishna kare. This is it. So, the highest perfection of life is to awaken our dormant Krishna consciousness. That is highest perfection. Everyone has got Krishna consciousness, dormant. It is covered by the influence of Maya. By the influence of Maya. That is also stated in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Yeah. Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti Sadhya Kobhu Naya. শ্রবণাদি শুদ্ধ চিত্তে করায়ুদ নিত্য সিদ্ধ কৃষ্ণ ইজ দি সুপ্রিম পার্সোনালিটি অফ গড এন্ড উই আর অল পার্ট অ্যান্ড পার্সেল অফ কৃষ্ণ সো দেয়ার ফোর আওয়ার রিলেশনশিপ উইথ কৃষ্ণ ইজ ন্যাচারাল ইট ইজ ন্যাচারাল জাস্ট লাইক মাই পার্ট অ্যান্ড পার্সেল অফ দি ফিঙ্গার সো উইদাউট ফিঙ্গার মাই বডি ইজ ইনফার্ট Finger must be. So, the existence of finger with this body, it is natural. Similarly, to remain with Krishna, that is our natural position, constitutional position. Remain with Krishna as cowherd boy, as gopi, as Krishna's father, Krishna's mother, Krishna's servant, Krishna's trees, Krishna's jhona, Krishna's flower. Krishna's Vrindavan land, remain with Krishna. In any form, if you like. Shanta, Dasa, Sokha, Vatsalya, Madhujya. In any mela, humor, he can remain with Krishna. That is our natural position. But when we try to imitate Krishna, to become an imitation Krishna, just like there are so many persons, they say, I am Krishna. This is Maya. Immediately, because we are trying to forget Krishna, our relationship with Krishna, immediately Maya captures. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhagavan chakare, pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. As soon as we desire to forget Krishna, or to rebel against Krishna, so why I shall serve Krishna? I am Krishna. Immediately, Maya is there. Side by side, Krishna is there. Apasat purusam purnam, Maya se jad apatryam. When, that day, after getting instruction from Narada, he wanted to write Srimad Bhagavatam. So he first of all meditated. Bhakti yogena manasi apasat purusam purnam mayas jad apasrayam. He saw both Krishna and his illusory energy apasrayam on the back side. So Krishna is never influenced by the illusory energy maya. We become and influenced by the Maya. Krishna, just like the cloud cannot cover the sun. It is our eyes which are covered by the cloud. We say that now the sun is covered by the cloud. No, that is not the fact. Sun is very, very big. Sun cannot be covered by cloud. It is our eyes which are covered by the cloud. Similarly, Maya, we are teeny, part and parcel of Krishna. Therefore, we are covered by Maya. Sometimes, not always. Krishna, when we forget Krishna. Krishna bhuliyaji bhagavan chakare, pasete maya tare japotiyada. As soon as we try to forget Krishna, immediately Maya is there. Therefore, the reversing process, if we want to go back again to Krishna, then Daividhesa Gunamai Mamo Maya Durattaya. You cannot go back to home, back to Godhead by your own speculation. That is not possible. Chirangavichinna. You can go on speculating to become one with God. That is another thing. But if you actually want to know God and see God, then as Krishna says, Mame Vada Prabhadante Mayami Dantarantite. Simply surrender to Krishna and Maya will give you no more trouble. You can see Krishna. This is the process. Therefore, Krishna says, Mayasaktamana Prat Yogam. Do, this is yoga system. It's called bhakti yoga. Bhakti yoga system. So a neophyte devotee should be engaged in temple worship. But if he does not make further improvement, if he sticks to the simply temple worship, then he remains a Kanishadikar, lower standard devotee. Lower standard devotee. But one has to become first standard devotee. At least one must a first standard devotee is very high position, spiritual position. But at least we must come to the second standard. The lower standard is Acharyaiva Harai Japujang Sudhayahati Natat Bhakteshu Charneshu Chabhakta Prakita Smitaha. Acha, this Acha Vigraha, Diti, Krishna, Acharyaiva Harai, the Diti of Krishna, Japujang Sudhayahati, with great devotion, and according to the rules and regulations, if one performs, that is very nice. But if he does not improve, not of bhakteshu charneshu, he does not become knowable to the devotees and other persons, then he remains a kanishtha adhikari, sabhakta prakita. Prakita means in the material platform. He does not actually promote it to the spiritual platform. If he simply remains. Therefore, along with the worship of Krishna in the temple, these hearings should be Savanam Kirtana. Just like we are doing. We do not engage only the devotees to the temple worship, but there must be program for hearing Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavata, the science of God. Otherwise, after some time, simply if you ring the bell, after time you will be disgusted and the whole thing will be lost, as it has become now in India. There is no instruction about Krishna consciousness. They simply attach to the temple and dwelling, and now it is now zero. Devotion is zero. So two things must go on. Parallel. Then if two things must go, then you are promoted to the second platform. Madhyamadhikari. Madhyamadhikari means, at that time, he sees four things. Ishara tadadhineshu balisheshu disastucha prema maitri kripa pekha jap karati sa madhyam. Madhyam. Ishara by Achar Vidhi. He understands Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God, by this process, by the regulative process, by the instruction of the spiritual master, by the regulative principle set up in the bhakti shastras, just like Narad Pancharatra, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. There are many. So at that time, if one comes from the lower platform to the, of course we must know that any devotee, either in the lower platform or in the second platform or in the first platform, they are to be considered as devotee. Not that because one is in the material platform, he is not devotee. He is also devotee. But he has to improve. The improvement means he must know what is Krishna. Simply, if he remains attached to the temple worship and does not try to understand who is a Krishna devotee and how he has to deal with others. Natat bhakteshu chaneshu. We have got some duty to others. This is preaching work. This is preaching work. One should not be satisfied simply by worshipping in the temple, then he'll remain a neophyte. He must become a preacher, Krishna consciousness. Then he comes to the second class. So when he becomes a preacher, he sees four things. He sees God, Krishna, Ishara, Tadadhina, and the devotees. Tadadhina means those who have accepted Krishna as the Param Purush. There is another verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Ittham brahma sukhanubhutya dasangatanam paradoibhuti. Dasangatanam, for the bhaktas, Krishna is the Supreme Lord, paradeva. Ittham brahma sukhanubhutya dasangatanam paradoibhutena mayasitanam naradarapena sadhan vijarahu kritapurna punya. When Sukadeva Goswami described the cowherd boy playing with Krishna, so he is remarking that these boys who are playing with Krishna, who is this Krishna? Ittham brahma sukhanubhutya. Those are impersonalists, those who are attached to the impersonal Brahma Jyoti. For them, he is the target. He is the target. From him, the Brahma Jyoti comes. Ittham Brahma Sukhanubhuti. And Dasangatanam Paradayata. And those who are devotees, for them, here is the Supreme Lord. Dasangatanam Paradayata. And Maya Sitanam Naradarakena. And those who are under the influence of Maya, for them, he is ordinary human child. The same person. Different views. One is saying that the ultimate target of Brahma Jyoti, and somebody is saying that he is the Supreme Lord, and somebody is saying that he is ordinary boy. Krishna is vision under different position, under different position, but he is the Supreme Lord. This yoga system, attachment for Krishna, begins from the temple vasi and ends into Mahabhagavata. Mahabhagavata means who simply sees Krishna, nothing. Sarvatra spurayata ishtadim. Thabar jangam dakhe na dakhe tar murti. Similarly in the Bhagavad Gita, Vidyabhinaya sampanne brahmane gavihasthe sunite ta sapate. Pandita samadarshe. He does not see anything but Krishna. A Mahabhagavat, when he sees a tree, he does not see the form of the tree, but he sees Krishna. That is Mahabhava. That he should not imitate. That is the highest stage, perfectional stage. But at least we come to the middle stage. What is that middle stage? So we must understand what is God, what is Krishna. Perfect understanding. And Tadadhin and his devotees. Ishara Tadadhila. Balis. Balis means innocent person. They are they do not know actually what is God. And Bishop. Bishop means envier. The four classes are men. God, his devotee, innocent person, and envious person. Demons. So the person who is promoted to the second stage, he'll deal with these four classes of division, different. Ishare prem. One should try to learn how to love Krishna. Yato bhakti radho khadita. That is first class. And ishare tadadhineshu balishu disasu. Prema. prema, love for Krishna and Maitri, and to make friendship with the devotees. Prema, Maitri, and Kripa, those who are innocent, one should be merciful. The devotee should be merciful. Just to awaken their Krishna consciousness. And this is Sucha, Upekha. And those who are envious, they should be rejected. These four classes. To try to love Krishna, to make friendship with devotees, and to give some service to the innocent public who does not know what is God. And those who are envious, asuras, they should be rejected. The Madhyamadhikari should not touch the demons, because maybe he may turn again be demon. Therefore, one should be very careful to associate with the demons. But when one becomes Uttamadhikari, Mahabhagava, he does not see anyone as demon. He sees everyone is worshipping Krishna. I am not worshipping. This is Mahabhava. Just like Radharani. Radharani always feels that I do not know how to love Krishna. Here is a gopi. How she loves Krishna. That is her. This is called Mahabhava. So we should not imitate Radharani, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is the symbol of Radharani's Mahabhava. He says that, I do not love Krishna. I do not know how to love Krishna. Then somebody says, why you are crying? Well, that is a show. I am making a show. I am crying. Then, what is the symptom? Now the symptom is, this, if I would have loved Krishna, then without him I have died long ago. I should have died. I am living still without Krishna. That means I do not love Krishna. This is Mahabhagavata. Separation. Aslishabha padaratam finastama marmahatam karotuva adarsana jatha tathava vidudhadulampata matvananathasya saivanapa. This is Mahabhagavata. Mahabhagavata should not imitate. But we should not remain also as Kanishtha Adhikari. We must come to the Madhyama Adhikari, middle stage. So these stages will be manifest gradually. If we simply try to develop our attachment for Krishna, so this is the beginning. Achcha, achcanam, samanam kirtanam Vishnu, smaranam padasevanam, achcanam, achcanam. Therefore, every grihastha, because grihasthas are busy in so many ways, they have no opportunity to preach, but they must take to archana. Every householder, they must, what is the difficulty? Just like we have got in this platform, deity of Radha Krishna. Everyone can install Radha Krishna deity at home. And under the instruction of spiritual master and sastric regulation, then if we engage ourselves in auction vidhi, then automatically all the anomalies of life will stop. Adu sadhya tato sadhu sanga. Atama bhajanakya, this akshan vidhi is one of the items of bhajan, bhajanakya. So anarthani is this. If every house engages in this akshan vidhi, so many unwanted things will vary. You'll have no more interest for seeing cinema, or going to the restaurant, or smoking bidi, and wasting time by unnecessary talks. So many things, and your life will be perfect. So many nonsense things will go automatically. Anartha nivittisya. So therefore, to become Krishna conscious, every house, everywhere, every person, every human being should adopt this Archanvita. Then at least he will save so many unnecessary anarthanivittisya. Arusadhyatato sadhusanga. So Krishna says that maya sattamana prartha. My dear Arjuna is addressed as partha, very familiar, because partha, Krishna, Arjuna's mother's name was Pritha, Kunti's name. So, and Pritha, Kunti, happened to be the aunt of Krishna. So he is very feelingly, in a familiar way, he is addressing partha, my dear Arjuna, partha. Maya asaktamana. Simply by increasing attachment for me. Maya asaktamana. Maya asaktamana prartha. Yogam. This is yoga. This is perfect yoga. Yogi nama kisake. Mad atraya. This yoga system should be executed directly under my direction or under the direction of a representative of mine. The spiritual master is the representative of Krishna. How he becomes representative? What is the test? The test is just like anyone can understand representative. Suppose a business firm's representative is going to canvas for business. What is his business? He will take the interest of the firm, not his personal interest. He will try to secure business for the firm he is working, not for his personal. That is perfect representative. And if he goes in the name of the firm's representative and he does his own business, then he is a liar. Similarly, Krishna's representative means one who speaks about Krishna as Krishna speaks. And if he adulterates, he is a liar. He is not a Buddha. He is not a Buddha. Krishna says, manmana bhava mad bhakta mad jari mang namaskuru. And if the representative says, just become a devotee of Krishna, just worship Krishna, just offer your obeisance to Krishna, he is a Buddha. Krishna says, sarvadharmān parityajya māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ vraja. And the representative will say that you give up all other process, you simply surrender to Krishna. He will never say that I am Krishna. He will never. He is not representative of Krishna, he is a liar. He is not representative. So to become representative of Krishna is not very difficult. Simply one has to become very sincere, that's all. That whatever Krishna says, he says. Just like Arjuna accepts it. Sarvavetam ritang manne jadvadasi kesava. That is the principle. My dear Kesava, Krishna, whatever you are speaking, I accept them all in total without any return. That is the principle. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Amaragdai Guru Haiya, Taro Eide, Jare Dakho Tare Kaho Krishna Purusha. Amaragdai, one has to carry out the order of God. He is the principle. Otherwise, liar, misnomer. So, therefore, Krishna says, Madasaya. Madasaya. Either under my direction, the direction is there, or my representatives, more. No, that is required.
Your Divine, in order to understand the Bhagavad Gita, we have to take yourself. You can explain what are the words of the Lord Krishna. And in order to understand yourself, we have to make the help of human nature. You will be in English and talk to us all the day.
One who eradicates the Ajnana, Andhakar, darkness. In the darkness, if somebody brings lamp, Ajnana Timirana, Jnananjana Salakaya, the Jnana Roop, your torch light, he is Guru. So, maybe different degrees, but anyone who opens the spiritual eyes is Guru. So, but in the Shastra it is said, Guru api kaja kajama jana. If I accept some Guru, but if later on it appears that he did not know what is to be done, what is to be not to be done, then Sri Jiva Goswami says that such Guru parityaga vidhiyat. Such Guru should be rejected. But it doesn't matter the degree. The actually, if the Guru teaches Krishna consciousness, then he may be in lesser degree, but he is accepted as Guru. There is no question of rejection. Because Krishna is actually Gyan. One who teaches Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one has to know Krishna, one has to surrender to Krishna. This kind of teaching is required. And if the Guru says that I am Krishna, everyone is Krishna, then Daridra Krishna, Daridra Nara, as he is not a Guru. He is not a Guru. He is misguiding.
Avaishnava Guru na sa syat
This is the Shastric injunction. Satkarma nipuna vipra mantra tantra visharat. Generally, a qualified brahmana becomes guru. That is natural. Brahmana is the head of the society. So he, without becoming brahmana, nobody can become guru. That is also fair. Because brahmana means brahma janati iti brahma. One who knows brahma. So guru must be a brahmana. Mane qualified brahmana, not born brahmana. So called brahmana. Qualified. So, still, brahmana's qualification, satkarma, pathan, pathan, jajan, jajan, dan, pratigya. So, Shastra says, satkarma nipuna vipra, if one vipra is quite expert in executing the six kinds of business, and mantra tantra visharada, and it's very well known in the Vedic mantras and hymns and everything complete. But if he is a Vaishnava, if he is not Vaishnava, he does not know Vishnu Tattva or Krishna Tattva, then he cannot become spiritual master. A Vaishnava Guru Nasasya, Shat Vaishnava Sapacha Guru. But if a Vaishnava, one who knows Vishnu Tattva, Krishna Tattva, even if he is born in the family of Sapacha, the dog eaters, Chandal, he can be accepted as Guru. So the real test is whether the Guru is a Vaishnava, whether he knows the science of Krishna. That is also confirmed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Kiva vipra kiva sudra nasikane noy. Jai Krishna tattva vetta sei guru hai. It doesn't matter what he is, whether he is a sannyasi or a grihastha or a brahman or born in brahmana family. It doesn't matter. Jai Krishna tattva, anyone who knows Krishna, he can become. Not us. So that is the statement of the Shastra. If a Vaishnava cannot become Guru.
In your presence I may declare also admitting that I have found your wisdom of Krishna consciousness is there and very practical. That is why I have
Hare Krishna.